अस्सलाम
वालेकुम सलाम। गुड इवनिंग सर।
और यूज़बर।
नाइस सर, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह।
ओके गुड। वी हैव टू स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर एंड ग्रुप डिस्कशन ऑन प्रोफेशन टुडे
यस सर।
After a few minutes now, we have to start the proper class. Maybe the students have to join this class. Sorry, Sujad.
I am fine, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Today, we have to discuss about professions. Yesterday I gave you briefing on professions. Today we have to start question answers, and also we have to start group discussion today. I wanted that everybody have to take part in group discussion, and but you need care about it, that your answers should be according to questions. Don't go in unnecessary detail. Yes, but in you know that if you have to start presentation, so you can go in detail. I will not stop you. But if I ask you about a question, so you have to reply me according to question. You have to listen my question carefully, then you can reply well. You can give me correct answer. So now I will ask you questions, and anyone can reply me. And in group discussion, same here. Everybody can take part in group discussion on professions, and also you can start presentations when I will say you. Let I ask first question regarding professions. Anyone can define two professions.
If somebody devotes his time daily for earning purpose, so it is called profession. People have to earn money daily and devote their time and get money. People have to devote their time and energy. Spend the time devotion than energy.
Quite right now. Yes, further? Anyone can reply me? Anyone?
About importance?
About definition of professions.
Okay. So definitions, professions means, sir, it is if any person or somebody is devote their times and energy for earning purpose for daily basis. Is called profession, sir.
Yes. Okay.
We especially give our profession in our energy, our time, and yes, sir.
Okay.
For profession, sir.
Okay, right. Anyone can define two professions quite well now. Both of you. Yes, further, anyone can define two professions? Everybody should take part in in session of question answers. Okay, next question I ask you, why professions are important for us? What is the importance of professions for us?
Yeah. May I, sir?
Anyone can apply, no problem.
Okay. Profession is more important for us, and profession have great importance in our life, because as a human being we have desire, so people fulfill their desire by professions.
Yeah.
And profession is important for our life and our survivals. So that's why profession is compulsory for our life. That nobody is. Can deny the importance of professions, and professions play major role in our life, because we have basic needs in daily routine. So we fulfill their needs by professions, and for our fulfillment, for needs, we have to get money in different forms, because people have to earn money on salary and profit basis. So that's why in this scene profession is important for us.
Quite right. Yes, anyone can explain it now? Why? Anyone can tell me about importance of professions? Same question.
Profession is great importance in our life. Professions are important for our survival. Nobody can deny about profession. Nobody can survive without profession. People have to get money on salary wage. Profession are important for human being. Nobody live without profession.
What question? No. Okay, ask you next question. What are two main types of professions?
There are two types, sir. Jobs and business.
Certainly. Now, you tell me now, can you give me examples regarding jobs and professions? There are also two types of jobs. What are two main types of jobs?
Sir, government or private job?
Yes, government service and private job. Why not? Yes, anyone can tell me that how many types of businesses?
Sir, business have many types, numberless types, sir.
There are numberless types of businesses. Why not?
For example, import-export business, shoe business, cloth business, hoteling business, pawn shop, truck shop, car dealer, motorbike, etc.
Of course. Jazubar, you want to say something?
Yeah. Sir, there are two types of professions. First is job, and second one is business. A large number of people are engaged in jobs as a professions. Approximately 80% people are busy in jobs as a professions, yes, and 20% people are busy in their business.
Yes, certainly.
We can divide two types of professions, job and business. Jobs mean people have to work from morning to evening, and people have to devote their times and energies. People have to provide the services, and people have get salary after 1 month.
Okay.
There is two type of jobs, government jobs and private jobs. Government jobs, like government services, provide provide much facilities. Much facilities. There is job security, accommodation facilities, and government services is pensionable. And in private jobs, no security, no accommodation, and no pension. But salary is common in private and government jobs. And second hand business, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, quite right now. Now you have to tell me, can you tell me about what problem people have to face regarding professions? Can you throw light? What type of problem people have to face regarding professions?
Mostly people are illiterate. Mostly people have no skills. Mostly people cannot afford the fee. Mostly people cannot take good decision. Mostly people are unconscious. That's it, sir.
Okay, quite well. Quite right. Further, anyone can throw light. What problem do you have to face regarding professions? People have faced many problems, so I have to reply now, Zen Treadwell. Many problems people have faced regarding professions. First of all, most people are illiterate, as Zen said. On the other hand, people have not interest in their professions because people have to adopt any profession without any interest by force from parents. You know, there is unemployment too much in underdeveloped countries like Pakistan. So most people are, you know, helpless to join any job without interest, because people have many responsibilities at home. Nowadays, the price of goods are going on peak. Day by day, the price of goods are increasing. So people are helpless. People are ready to get any job. People don't care about education. Instead of somebody did master's in any subject, and if somebody did master's in 3 to 4 subjects, but he does not care about it, that he had to join any office as a peon. Further problems. There are further problems. Now I tell you that on the other hand, corruption is too much. Because mostly deserved people can't adopt good profession in the presence of corruption. Bribe and recommendation are two major parts of corruption. These are our problems people have faced regarding professions. And on the other hand, I tell you one thing, that first of all, illiteracy is the major hurdle to get good profession. On the other hand, most people are unconscious about different skills because most people can't afford the fee. And third one, most people are without experience. It's not fault of people. People have not jobs. People have not opportunities. So how people can get experience? So that's the major hurdle. For any profession, people need three major things. First of all, high education. Second one, people should be perfect in their skills. Third one, people need too much experience. Three, in the light of three conditions, then any person can good job. So these are major problems we face regarding to adopt good professions. These are common problems in underdeveloped countries. Why people, most people can't adopt or can't get good professions. I ask you next question. What are benefits regarding professions? Anyone can reply me. What benefits people have to get by professions? My question is this. Hi, everybody's quiet. You understand my question? What I asked you, what benefits people have to enjoy by professions?
Left from mind, sir.
Okay. People have to fulfill their basic needs by professions. People, because everybody need money. First of all, people have to fulfill their basic needs. People need proper shelter. People need bread. People need proper dressing. On the other hand, people need money for shopping. People have to participate in different functions or ceremonies. People have to join parties. So people have to go there with gifts, because, you know, man is social animal. So people have many desires. Everybody wants get status in the society. Everybody wants get prosperity in the society. So by professions, people have to get many benefits. People have peace of mind. People get knowledge. People get experience by professions. People have to get respect everywhere by professions. And people don't kill their time by professions. People, look healthy mentally and physically by professions. People have to avoid from many diseases by professions. People have to avoid from many quarrels and disputes by professions, because people have no time. So it's a good sign for people if people are engaged in different professions. So people have to get many benefits by professions. If somebody does work with an ST with struggle, most probably he will get the progress, and most probably he can make extraordinary, he can make as a role model, he can earn fame, he can make familiar, he can make famous, he can make noted. So person can make exemplary. These are other benefits of profession. If somebody does work with honesty and devotion with struggle, most probably person have to get extraordinary benefits. Also, Allah said it that somebody does work, does struggle, so he is the friend of Creator. He is the friend of Allah as a Muslim now. So people have to enjoy many benefits by professions. Okay, next question I ask you. I need your suggestions regarding professions. Anyone can reply me.
We should open more institute in our country. We should less the fee of institute. Parents should not force to their children for any cost. People should adopt their profession, their own choice. We should follow the teachings of Islam. We should read the Holy Quran. We should teach the people. Everybody should get education. That's it.
Okay, quite well now. Further, anyone can reply me. Do you have any suggestion regarding professions? So anyone can reply me. So I tell you about further suggestions. First of all, you know that we have to complete our education. First of all, we should do Masters in English Literature, then we have to learn English, spoken English language skill by all means at any cost. Best suggestion.
Yes,
by
sir.
Spoken English language skill, any person can get extraordinary success in any field. It is enough for him now. He can avail golden opportunities within country and out of country. Anyone can get the government service, and he can make government officer if he appears in CSS exam by FPSC. People can get extraordinary success in business if he is well conscious about spoken English language skill. Any person can get visa from embassy easily if he's perfect in spoken English language. Any person can go abroad, and any person can enjoy his life according to his choice. Any person can fulfill his desires by this extraordinary skill of spoken English language. I mean to say spoken English language skill. Any person can earn fame by this skill. Any person can make familiar by this skill. Any person can join any job on offer letter by this magic. On the other hand, person can make as a role model, any person can make exemplary, any person can get the success in this world, and any person can get respect everywhere, any person can get status in the society, further suggestions that if somebody wants join to government service, first of all he have to learn spoken English language skill. On the other hand, he have to, if he can't learn to spoken English language skill, it is impossible for him. So it's much better that he have to learn shorthand and typing skill. And if he gets speed 100 words per minute in shorthand and 40 words per minute in typing, most probably he can get job as a stenographer in government service in grade 16 easily, without recommendation, without corruption, on merit base. Best suggestion, if somebody wants join to government service as a profession. Other suggestions, we should not kill our time. If we are busy from morning till evening, so much better in the evening time, we have to learn any skill. But I prefer, first of all, any person have to learn spoken English language skill. Then other skills person have to learn, like computer courses and other courses. These are all suggestions now. If you have to learn any skill, so it is your own thing. Nobody can snatch it. It is your own property, and you can get benefit anywhere or any place. It's very precious knowledge if you have to learn any skill. All languages, if you have to learn many languages, so you have to get much benefit. I also prefer to Chinese language after English language. People have to learn Chinese language. After English language, people have to learn Chinese language. Coming time is very attractive for those people who would learn to Chinese language. First of all, people have to learn spoken English language, then people have to learn Chinese language. Best suggestion, because mostly people in future, most people have to go to China, will go to China. And mostly Chinese will come to Pakistan. Mostly Chinese are engaged to learn Urdu language nowadays. Some Pakistanis are busy to learn Chinese language. Mostly Pakistanis should learn to Chinese language. First of all, people have to learn spoken English language, then people have to learn Chinese language. These are best suggestions. Then you can avail golden opportunities in near future. Best suggestion. And you can adopt any profession, good profession. Mostly people have would go to China, and people have to adopt good professions in China. But there's a condition. People should know about English language and should know to Chinese language. These are two conditions. People should be perfect in spoken English language skill, and people should be expert in Chinese language skill now. If you have to learn spoken English language skill and you have to make expert, then you can make as a trainer, you can make as a teacher, you can make successful lecturer. Same here, if you have to learn Chinese language, you can make good teacher, you can make, many translators or many trainers need in future to teach English language and Chinese language. So you will avail golden opportunities in near future. These are best suggestions to get good profession. Further suggestions that we should follow to teachings of Islam. We follow to Holy Quran and Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Then miracles will take place, and any Muslim will achieve and get extraordinary successes in this world and in other world. We should obey our parents and teachers. We should follow our parents and teachers. If our parents and teachers guide us, so we should listen them and we should follow them. It is way of success. Because parents and teachers will not misguide you. These are best suggestions. We should avoid from bad company. We should join to good company. We should make good friends. We should avoid from bad friends. We should study daily. We should listen to scholars. We should sit with scholars. We should follow our leaders. These are best suggestions. We should follow to our leaders in their professions, in their hobbies. Most probably we will make leaders. I give you a guarantee now. I need your point of view just in one sentence. Anyone can reply me just in one sentence as a point of view regarding professions? Just in one sentence, can you reply me as a point of view on professions?
Sir, in my point of view, as a professional, I joined the business rather than a job, sir.
Because why? Why?
Because, sir, business make us so much wealthy, and better for our family, sir.
Okay. So it, yes, is your, sir, point of view. Good point of view. I confess it. I accept it.
Yes, sir.
As a point, yes, your point of view. Yes. Further, anyone can tell me about professions, and anyone has a point of view. Just in one sentence. So my point of view, that we have to choose any profession according to our, willing. If we are willing, and if we have interest in any profession, so according to our choice, we have to choose any profession. But there is one condition. First of all, we have to complete our master's in English literature, and by all means we have to learn English language. So concerned person can join any profession according to his choice. It is my point of view. Now, it is the time of presentations. As a practice now, everybody have to speak for 3 minutes on professions as a presentation. Yes, who will take a start first?
Sir, may I? Sir?
I mean to say that you have to start presentation on professions for 3 minutes. Yes. It is practice, not test.
Okay, sir. Sir, professions, definition of professions. Profession mean if any person devote their time and energy for earn purpose for daily basis is called profession. And importance, profession have great importance in our life. And profession is most important for our life. All humans have desires, so people fulfill their desires from professions. Profession are part of our life and important for our survival. So professions are obligatory for our life. Nobody can deny the importance of the professions. and professions do major role, play major roles in our life. Nobody can survive without professions.
Okay. Further? Tried well now?
Others, types of professions, sir.
Okay.
There are two types of professions. First is job and second is business. A large number of people are engaged in jobs and as a profession. And people have to devote their times and energies are both like jobs and business. People have to provide the services and people have to get salary after 1 month. We can divide jobs in two parts, government jobs and private jobs. And like, and other than business, business means people have to invest money in business and get profit on daily, weekly, fortnight or monthly basis. And some businessmen have get profit in 6 months or 1 year. There is major difference between jobs and businesses. People have to get salary in business. Salary and in business, people have to get profit. There are different types of jobs. First of all, in government jobs, there are many designations like secretary, chief secretary, commissioner, assistant commissioner, and LDC, UDC, peon, typist, driver, stenotypist, teachers, and armed forces like that, pilots, engineer, lieutenant, colonel, captains, commander, major, lance naik, naik, etc. In private jobs, in executive, sales managers, director, cashier, accountant, etc. And business, type of businesses in import, exports, and factories, garments, pawn shops, transport, travel agencies, air tickets, mobile shops, etc. Sir, there are numberless jobs and business in the world, sir. So that is kind of jobs and businesses and professionals, sir.
Well done. Yes, anyone? Okay. So I give you a simple briefing again on professions. Maybe you can find new things from this briefing. Instead of you have all my lectures on YouTube, and you can get last lecture from YouTube according to need. Instead of I have to start again. Presenting because it's a very important topic. Okay, so let us start. What are professions now? I want to tell you one thing that according to main points, you can speak well on any topic. You do not, you should not forget main points from your mind, and you should keep in your mind main points or regarding any topic. Then you can speak well. I tell you one thing that main. Main points are same in different topics, and you should save in your mind. Professions means if people have to spend their time for earning purpose daily, and people have to devote their energies. So it is called profession. Nobody can deny the importance of professions. Professions are part of our lives. People have to fulfill their basic needs. So how people can fulfill their basic needs? By money. How people can get money? If people have to adopt any profession. By profession, people have to fulfill their financial needs. People have to fulfill their basic needs. Nobody can deny the importance of professions. In all over the world, people are engaged in different professions. Professions are part of our lives. Professions are obligatory for our lives. Professions are compulsory for our lives. Nobody can survive without professions. There are two main types of professions, jobs and business. What are jobs? Jobs mean people have to get salary after 1 month. People have to devote their time and energies daily, and people have to get salary after 1 month as income. And the other type of profession is business. People have to invest their money in different businesses and get profit on daily basis, weekly, fortnight, or monthly. But actual purpose is same. People have to earn money. If people are engaged in jobs or businesses, but their purpose is same, people have to earn money. There are different types of jobs. Approximately 80% people are engaged in jobs in the world, and approximately or almost 20% people are engaged in different type of businesses in the world. I can't ignore to armed forces. There are ranks in armed forces. Ranks like lieutenant, colonel, major, Lance Naik. I talk about Pakistan Air Force, Commodore, Air Commodore, pilots, in Navy captain. In armed forces, there are ranks. Keep in mind this thing now, ranks. Not designations. Ranks. Ranks in armed forces. We say ranks. And in private jobs or government jobs, we say designations. Designations. But in armed forces, we say ranks, and in jobs, we say designations. You have to keep difference between ranks and designations. Now, next point I have to tell you about problems. What type of problems people have to face regarding professions? Why most people can't get good jobs according to their choice? First of all, most people are illiterate. On the other hand, unemployment is going on peak. Third thing, now parents have to say by force to their children, you have to make doctor, you have to make pilot, you have to make lecturer, you have to make professor, you have to make teacher. You have to join government job. You have to go abroad. On the other hand, the son and daughter has different mind. If you know their daughters and sons have to follow their parents and achieve their goals, but they don't take interest in their professions, so their lives like hell. On the other hand, corruption is going on peak. In underdeveloped countries like Pakistan, no merit, mostly deserved people or talented people can't get good jobs according to their choice. In the presence of corruption, in the presence of bribe, in the presence of recommendations, mostly deserved people are disheartened and look hopeless and look disappointed. And mostly talented people say goodbye to Pakistan and go to foreign countries and promote them and develop to foreign countries and play a major role in the development of advanced countries. It is tragedy with Pakistan. On the other hand, if people are jobless, mostly talented people can't get good profession.